right, what's up, gang? We're gonna be talking about golfer's elbow and tennis elbow. How about just elbow pain? It's super easy to fix because the problem is it's not normally an elbow issue. It's mostly a upstream downstream issue. So imagine the elbow is like the knee. So the elbow likes to hinge. That's about it. And I see a lot of stuff on InstaCoachland and YouTube where people are addressing the problem with the elbow itself. So they're smashing away on the extensors, they're hammering the flexors, and neither one of them are gonna fix the problem. Usually it's an issue with shoulder mechanics. They start to roll forward, so we need to unload that lat, that teres, all kinds of stuff in there. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna basically unload the shoulder, we're gonna reclaim all that elbow mobility, unload the wrist, and give you the ultimate elbow hack. It's just that easy. So when it comes to the wrist, remember this, we have circumduction in the wrist. So we have 360 degree ranges of motion in the wrist and the shoulder. And the shoulder is pretty much the most mobile joint in the body and the most unstable joint because it just has that little rubber band around the inside, that labrum, that allows the head of that humerus to sit inside that labrum or sit inside that glenoid fossa. So when you go overhead, or if you're a pitcher, for example, it's a really good one, you wind up and you throw the ball, your deceleration, if your shoulder mechanics are off, is done by the extensors on the forearm, which means that to keep your hand from flying off, these have to fire. But the problem is that they're gonna do that all the time. And most of the time, you see these guys, they're telling you you have to strengthen the wrist extensors, and that's 100% opposite and wrong. It's usually the flexors that are weak, because these, so what happens is you wind up in this really muted rolled forward position. So long head of the bicep, lat, teres, subscap, pec, they all roll you forward and internal. So what ends up happening is as you roll internal, you make these long and stretched, which actually heats them up, gets them tired, and then forces everything to kind of shut off. But now they don't work the way they're supposed to. These get recruited to take over. So when you look at something like a pull-up, for example, you go wide on your pull-up and you go to pull up in your position, you can't do it because your grip's off. What ends up happening is you start to roll your forearms forward and pull yourself in this way, and you'll catch yourself doing it every single time, because most of your strength is gonna come from these two fingers right here, this thumb and this finger. When you grab onto something, these three are kind of along for the ride, but what ends up happening is since these are really tired, and in order, like according to the principle of radiation, just to give you an idea, when you flex to make a fist, when you grip on anything, both extensors and flexors have to engage. So to get rid of golfer's elbow, tennis elbow, all that, or vice versa, golfer's elbow and tennis elbow, all that stuff, basically lateral epicondylitis, medial epicondylitis, you have to reclaim shoulder mechanics, train how the shoulder works, and retrain how the grip engages under movement, under metabolic load, and how things operate. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. Check this out, this is super easy. So first thing is, let's hack your pull-up a little bit, because if you're gonna be anything like me, let's move this just a bit, try not to wake up Ian. So what happens is, if you're anything like me, you're not gonna stop training. So I'm gonna show you a little trick to allow you to train. So we go like this. You can see, we take a band. So this is a 1-inch band. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put the band underneath these three fingers. So we're gonna grab onto the band, and then we're gonna put the finger on the outside of the band. So I'm basically taking these right here and I'm grabbing the bar, and these three fingers right here are going over the band, so they're not even gonna engage. So I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna do the same thing on this side, and then when I do my pull-up, I'm actually doing the bulk of the work with just these, so I can still do my pull-ups if that's how you're gonna be. So that's just a little hack to help you do pull-ups to kind of unload that elbow so you don't have all this elbow pain when you're doing it. All right, now what we wanna do is unload the shoulder so you actually get that range of motion of elbow, because what your body's doing right now is feeding slack into the system at the elbow in an effort to reclaim some of that motion. So what we do is we take a band, we take the band, we put it against the rig, and we take a med ball. So you can see I've got the band there without smashing our shins into the med ball. We load into here, we wind up, so I'm in the band like this. I'm gonna wind up on the band. Now the med ball is underneath my scapula, and I'm gonna lay on my back, and I'm gonna let the band pull the shoulder open. I'm gonna keep that elbow locked out, and I'm gonna hang out in this position for how long? 2 minutes. That's number one, unload that. Number two is we wanna undo both flexion and extension of the wrist. It sounds super easy, but a lot of you guys aren't doing it right. So same thing, take the band, we're gonna load the band, in the crease of the wrist. Now, I don't want you to put any weight. There's not gonna be any work done on this. We just wanna unload the tissue so we can get to work with the rest of the stuff. So we're gonna take the band, load the wrist, clamp down, and then just find that spot where you start to feel it on the inside here. Don't worry, we're gonna get to that ulnar nerve in a second too. So really just hang out in this position for how long? 2 minutes. That's number two. Number three is we're gonna load the band this way. So now I've got my palm in, I'm gonna get on top of it, and I'm gonna hold this position again. Same thing, now I'm getting on the extensors on the outside. Make sure you're not rolling that elbow around. 2 minutes. Now, this is the fun one. So the ulnar nerve runs down the inside in the elbow. We wanna floss that nerve a little bit. There's all kinds of fancy bring the hand out, twist it all over the place stuff. Or there's a really easy way, and you can do it when you're watching television. You're gonna take the hand, this is so trick, you're just gonna flip it around, and you're gonna hang out like this. That's it, literally, that's it. You're unloading the ulnar nerve at the elbow. You're gonna take the hand, really spin it around. So I'm basically facing the other direction with my palm, and I'm gonna hang out like this. 2 minutes when I'm done, come off, unload the hand. So it's forcing flexion at the elbow and extension and rotation at the wrist. It's a lot easier than spinning your hand all over the place like Cirque du Soleil. Now comes the fun part. We wanna take a kettlebell, and we wanna reclaim how the forearm works. So this is gonna work on shoulder stability. There's one more we're gonna do for shoulder stability. This is gonna work on shoulder stability. More importantly, how that forearm engages under load. So we take the kettlebell, flip it upside down. If you catch my vlog, I just did this with Jay. So take the kettlebell, flip it upside down, elbows in the front. This is light, like this is like a 4 kilogram. It's super light. We're just gonna drive straight up overhead and then come all the way back down. I want this elbow to track all the way behind the ear and then back down. 3 sets of 10 while squeezing on to this kettlebell, otherwise you get it in the face. And I can think of better things to do than that. Last thing, since those shoulders are rolling in, I'm gonna give you the ultimate external rotation drill, and it's really easy. And you just saw this today. So we take the band, palms up, elbows glued at the sides, shoulders pushed down, and believe it, all this stuff has to do with your forearm. Unload the shoulder, fix your forearm. And just externally rotate and back. You're just loading this on and off. So you're hitting the teres minor, subscap, or teres minor, infra supraspinatus. The 3 out of the 4 rotator cuff muscles that do external rotation and pull that shoulder back into the socket where it's supposed to be. Hey, listen, I'm Trev, hanging out at CSA, SmashweRx. You know how it works. I'll check you guys out tomorrow. Have a good day.